This is going to be a fraud like you've never seen.
This is all about trying to dissuade people from voting.
As far as the ballots are concerned, it's a disaster.
You will determine the outcome of this election.
A lot has changed this year. Well, US President Donald Trump doesn't think so. He wanted to delay the election, arguing a big increase in postal voting because of coronavirus would lead to widespread fraud. But he didn't win that battle, and the election is due to go ahead on November the 3rd. So, have other countries managed to hold elections? And were they successful? Let's start in South Korea. The authorities decided to go ahead with the parliamentary election back in April. Voting was a very different experience, with social distancing, masks, and temperature checks at polling stations. Anyone with a high temperature was taken to a separate area to vote. People self-isolating had to cast their ballots at specific times of day, in designated locations. And they had to call medical officials when they got home, or risk a visit from the police. Many people voted in advance, either by post or at polling stations which opened several days early. Was it a success? Well, turnout was up on previous years. In fact, it was the highest in 18 years, with 66% of eligible voters casting a ballot. Meanwhile, in Europe, France decided to go ahead with local elections in March, but unlike South Korea, turnout was much lower than expected, a fact many put down to people staying at home because of fears about the virus. Again, hand sanitizer, face masks, and social distancing were all observed at polling stations. One minister even asked people to bring their own pens to help stop the spread of the virus. Lockdown meant a second round of voting was postponed a few months until June. Low turnout was a key feature again. Only 40% of the electorate voted. Singapore, which was initially praised for its handling of the virus, soon became a hotspot in Asia. But that didn't stop it holding a general election in July. Mass gatherings had already been banned, so campaign rallies were mostly, but not entirely, conducted online. Some opposition party members complained that would badly affect their chances. They argued that older voters and the less tech-savvy wouldn't get their campaign message. Party activists were allowed to carry out door-to-door canvassing, albeit in smaller numbers. On polling day, voters had to put on gloves before being given their ballot paper. They were also given time slots at polling stations to avoid overcrowding. And mobile polling teams took ballot boxes to citizens who were in quarantine. So, some countries have managed to hold elections relatively successfully, but decisions about whether to go ahead or postpone have caused headaches elsewhere. In Africa, for example, Burundi's presidential election went ahead in May, despite concerns from the World Health Organization. It was worried that mass campaign rallies would spread the virus. And there were few international election observers after the government warned they would have to quarantine for 14 days. Meanwhile, in Hong Kong, pro-democracy activists and opposition parties were furious that the election there was postponed until September next year. They claim the pandemic is being used to suppress democracy. Confidence in some democracies around the world was low even before coronavirus. At least 111 election events were postponed at some point this year. What does all this mean for the US presidential election? Well, the country has more confirmed cases of coronavirus than any other nation. How will Election Day 2020 be remembered?